Assalamu alaikum. I am MD Fahim Muntasir. My ID is 171351900. So today I discuss about Android malware detection. So that is overview. These topics I will discuss today: Android malware dataset, machine learning algorithm, deep learning algorithm, evaluation metrics. So at first we need to know what is Android malware detection. Android based smartphone users can download a lot of free application from Android application market or Play Store. These download apps sometimes contain malware application that can possession of private information from users. So here we see the diagram of Android malware detection. Here raw data, pre-processing, feature extraction, feature comparison, training, testing, classification algorithm, detection result. So this step I will briefly describe in my next slide. Here data sets. This data set used for Android malware detection: Draven, Virus Share, Virus Total, Storm Droid, Brainsmark. We use data set for Android malware detection because data set object is designed to encourage the use of optimistic concurrency for long running activities such as remoting data and interacting with data. So how algorithms are used to detect Android malware? Here I see two diagrams. First one is machine learning and second one is deep learning. Here I am discussing an algorithm for machine learning algorithms that are most used for Android malware detection. And secondly, here I am discussing an algorithm for deep learning algorithms that are most used for Android malware detection. In next slide, I briefly describe this. Here, first, support vector machine is a hyperplane that separates both classes with a maximal margin based on the training data set that includes Bing and malicious application. Secondly, KNN proposed a static analysis based system called DroidMAT that exploited that static information, including permission deployment of components. And third one is NAPBase, used for solving binary or multi-class classification issue for prescient modeling by calculating the probabilities for each figure. And then the last one is random forest. Random forest is an assembly classification algorithm that joins various decision trees and returns the method of individual decision by decision tree. So as k-means is a clustering algorithm where tests are branched into n cluster. Then decision tree develops classification model as a tree structure by separating a dataset into little subset and makes the conscious outcome as a tree with decision node having two or more branches. Then logistic regression is a order method that learns and feeds the information depends on log it function. J48 decision tree is a factual classifier that contains a decision tree depend on data entropy. Now I describe deep learning. First of all, deep neural nets that used a number of detection approach based on DNN. Second one, CNN. CNN had DCNN that is based on VGG16 and input layer, convolution layer, pooling layer, full connection layer, and output layer. And third one is DBN, deep brief network. DBN is compromised of RBM. For compromising DBM, they need to follow some formula. DBN is associated with a bipartite undirected graph. RBM, the group of RBM has only connection between the layer of hidden and visible variables. LSTM can solve the prediction problem in sequential data. RNN use hidden units for maintaining sequential information and learns to classify string data. So that's the evaluation matrix. Here recall, precision, accuracy, F1 score, F1 measure, TNR, APR curve. This is the evaluation matrix. Final result are provided based on this evaluation matrix. Here is the example. Here we see some percentage. Here NAP by JFOTS algorithm percentage. Here in the left side, dataset percentage. From this table, we can easily decide our accepted algorithm and accepted dataset. So that is the example how provide result. From this table, we easily calculate our goal and we make sure our decision. So everyone, thank you for watching my video.